and I went over and saw her at the hospital. She was doing pretty well, slightly feisty still, which is a good sign. And so she and I used to kind of needle each other in a friendly way. And we were, I was kind of teasing her, and she was teasing me. And then the doctor walked in to this hospital room, and mother said, "Do you want to know why George W. is the way he is, doctor?" And doctor kind of didn't have any choice. And mother said, "Because I drank and smoked when I was pregnant with him." And so I knew she was feeling pretty good. And then a week later, she went downhill. She chose no, didn't want to have any life-sustaining care. In other words, she's ready to move. And they made her comfortable. And I called her yesterday when I had the sense that she was ready to go. She couldn't talk back, but I told her how much I loved her. And my brothers and sisters did the same thing. And then she was by Dad's side. I'm comfortable with her passing because she was comfortable with her passing. And she told me point blank, "I do not fear death. I know there's a loving God." And I told our daughters and some of my brothers and sisters, "Wow, what a beautiful, beautiful lesson."
What advice did your mom give you about being president of the United States?
Keep your eye on the ball, keep your nose to the grindstone, and I told her that's a hell of a position to be in.
A little awkward.
Yeah. Now she said, "Just do your, let's not talk to her." People, a lot of psychobabble about my relationship with my parents during the presidency, and it's natural because people haven't had a chance to ask many presidents what's it like to be president with your father being a former president and mother a former first lady. And the most important thing they told me was, "Son, I love you and we're proud of you," which is the most important thing any parent can tell a child.